God has created this entire universe, and the Quran speaks a lot about how it has taken so many days and mountains and this and that, and life is going to be a test and whatnot. My question is, way before God decided to create this entire universe, before he decided to put human beings, before he decided to send Prophet Muhammad or Adam and Eve, way before he even planned about doing any of this, he knew the end result of it. He knows in the end he will be disappointed by certain people and he will throw them in hellfire. He knows they will be burning. He knows they'll be tortured, and that is when they'll be repenting for what they've done. Way before he created the entire universe, he knows the outcome is gonna be bad. It may be good for certain people who are in heaven, but he knows that he can save those people from being in hell, way before he even decided to go ahead with the creation. Yet he decides to go ahead with it, with all his godly logic. Why would he want to do that? The question, if I can just put it in this manner, how can God be so sadistic?
The brother asked the question that Almighty God knows everything. Before he created the heaven and the earth, before he created human being, even if one person goes to
he could avoid
hell,
that.
Hell, he could have avoided that.
I mean, he could avoid being disappointed.
Of course. I'll reply. The brother said, even if one person goes to hell, it is as though God would be disappointed. Now coming to your question, I started a school, and you may have heard Islamic International School. If a teacher takes an examination, if she is just, while she is giving the examination, she writes in the maths paper 2 plus 2 is equal to how much? The student in front of her or him, the teacher, writes 5. She can very well tell the student, change 5 to 4. Would it be just on the teacher during the test and examination to correct a student who's writing a wrong answer?
Right, but if she has an option that the student doesn't need to do any of that and still
I'm asking a simple question. The teacher has given the question paper.
Right.
All the students are informed about it.
You're right. For that particular situation,
for that particular situation, the teacher can tell, dear student, change 5 to 4. What will the other students think about?
Unjust. But
correct.
God can be just at the same time. He can create a completely different condition. He doesn't have to go ahead with that situation. He's not bound by any situation.
Brother saying, Almighty God can create something which is perfect and will not make mistake, correct? That
right.
God has already done. He created the angels. God
right.
created the angels. The angel never go against any commandment of God. But human being is a better creation than angel. The angels have got no free will of their own. If you have heard my tapes, if you have not heard, I'll tell you now. The angels are a creation of Almighty God, but not the best creation. Almighty God created the human beings. The human being, they have a free will to go against God or to follow God. If you have chosen to be a human being, if you disobey his commandments, you go to hell. If you obey his commandments, you're superior than the angel. Because the angel doesn't have a free will of his own, then he follows God. It's nothing great. The human beings are the better creation of Almighty God. Almighty God has given a free will. That's a different question that Almighty God knows. Because he has ilme ghaib, he has knowledge of the future, he is more superior. So he has created such a creation which has a free will. The fault is of human being, not God.
No, but God has created us with that fault, and he knows he
not
can avoid
fault.
That.
Not fault, it's not fault, brother, it is free will.
But why is he giving us a free will when he knows he's going to eventually put these many people in hell? Why is he doing something?
That is a different creation. Like, would you want to create something which can think on its own, or would
why
you want
would
to
someone so compassionate be can
that,
also
brother,
be
that's what I tell you.
Time.
What you want, God has already created an angel. I'm asking you, which is better, an angel following Almighty God or a human being following Almighty God? Which is better?
For me, absolutely, if I get a second chance, I would want to be an angel. Why would I risk
second
going to
chance?
Hell?
Correct. That's why Almighty God says in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse number 172, Almighty God bought all the human beings from the loin of Adam and asked them, is there one God? All agreed. Almighty God says in Surah Hashar, chapter 59, verse number 21, if Almighty God revealed the Quran on the mountain would shatter down. Almighty God says in Surah Ahzab chapter 33 verse number 72, it is the human beings who were fools who said we want to be human beings. You and I were fools. Now you cannot backtrack. Once you said you want to appear for the test, once you read the test paper,
nobody asked me. They asked Adam and Eve.
No, brother. Quran says every human being was asked. And then it is washed off. This memory is washed off. If the memory is away, the test, Almighty God says in the Quran, do you want to be a human being? If you become a human being, you can become superior to an angel or can get inferior. If you don't want to become a human being, just pass.
Let me complete.
You ask the question.
Right, go.
If you interject, I will answer.
Sure, go ahead.
So Almighty God asked the human beings, and the Quran says, we human beings were fools, you and I both, were fools who opted for the test. Now, once you undergo a test, if you follow the commandment after free will, you be superior to an angel. If you disobey Allah, you become inferior to an angel. We wanted to pass with distinction, you and I. You told, I don't remember. Of course you will not remember. And even I don't remember, but I believe in the Quran. On the day of judgment, Almighty God says, not a single human being will object to the justice of Allah. That we'll come to know on the day of judgment. Only thing we'll say, please give us one more chance, Almighty God will say it's too late. Because if He wants to give you a new chance, even I'll have to come back in the world again. Again, everyone. So those who failed, He can't get only the failures. So the Quran says, no one will ever object on the justice of Allah. They will request Allah, give us one more chance. Almighty God said, too late. Almighty God gives us chances in this world itself. You make a mistake, Allah gives you a chance to repent. You repent, Allah forgives you. Again, you make a mistake. Once you die, it's only one. So as far as the first question is concerned, why did God create? Because it's a better creation. Any logical person, including you, has to agree that a person who has the free will is a better creation than a person who has no free will. Only your question you don't remember is perfectly right. When you die, when you're resurrected, that time you and I will meet. Then you will say, I remember. Even I don't remember now. But I have faith in the Quran, that Quran cannot be wrong, because scientifically, if you heard my lecture, 80% of the Quran is 100% matching with science. 20% is ambiguous, neither right, neither wrong. So my logic says, when 80% is 100% correct, and not even 0.1% of the 20% is wrong, so my logic says, even this 20% would be right. I'm a scientific person, I'm a logical person. So I believe in the statement of the Quran, that we chose. If you wouldn't have chosen, you could have questioned God, why did you make me a human being? Then God would have been at fault. But God says in the Quran, He asked. The mountains were afraid. Everything else were afraid. We human beings opted for this.
But do you remember being asked? I don't remember being asked.
Brother, if you heard my answer, even I don't remember. But if you remember, where is the test? Imagine if a teacher teaches you something. Teacher gives you the book. The teacher has to take away the book for the test. If the teacher says, okay, take the book and answer, where is the test?
Okay, but what?
After the examination is over, you can go home and check or not.
But even before the exam began, God
brother,
knows.
Brother, listen to me. After the examination is over, can you go and check home or not in the textbook?
Absolutely.
But during the examination, can you check?
No.
So now the examination is going on, brother. Once it's over, you can check. If you tell teacher, I want to see the textbook, I don't remember. No. During the examination, you cannot refer to the textbook. It will be called cheating. Correct? So once the examination is over, if you don't remember, you tell God, what is this illogical? But Quran says not a single human being will object to the justice. Let the test get over. So today, I being a scientific person, I being a logical person, based on my knowledge of science, based on my logic, when I read the other scriptures and when I read the Quran, I find Quran is the only book, only religious scripture on the face of the earth which passes this test. So therefore I, being a scientific person, being a logical person, agree, okay, fine. This statement of the Quran also has to be right. I don't remember, that's the test. If I remember, where is the test? So that answers the first part of the question. First part, that saying that God was sadist. God is not sadist. For example, I start a medical college. I want the school students to go to medical. How many students who go to school enter the medical college? Just roughly, can you guess? Few, surely less than 5%. Less than maybe 1%. So why did you make a college where only one person can enter? Fine, it is for selected few. So same way God made heaven, Jannah, Jannat-e-Firdaus. Everyone cannot go to Jannat-e-Firdaus.
Why not?
Sorry?
Why not?
Why can't everyone go to medical college?
Because it's human capacity. If humans were capable of being able to put everyone to medical college, they would.
That's the way we are made. The same way everyone cannot become a doctor. Only those who have the capacity. Same way everyone cannot go to Jannat-e-Firdaus, the high levels of paradise. We have to strive. God has given you capacity. If you don't follow His guidance, you cannot. If you follow His guidance, to go to Jannah is very easy. If you're intelligent, it's very easy. If you're intelligent, and if you're truthful to yourself. But if you're not truthful to yourself, even a non-intelligent man can go to Jannah. Only thing, you should be truthful. God has given you different options how to follow Him. Some people think they are smart. I tell them they're extra smart. If they were smart, they would see it is crystal clear in black and white that this is the word of God. You have to follow it. That's the reason Francis Bacon said, little knowledge of science makes you an atheist. In-depth knowledge of science makes you a believer in God. So I wouldn't say God is sadist. I said we were fools who opted to undergo the test. Not God. God gave you an option. What do you want to be? We chose. So we are responsible, not God. God is not a sadist. We are fools. That's what the Quran says. On the day of judgment, you'll come to know, inshallah, you and I both. Inshallah, if I go to Jannah, inshallah, inshallah, I'll pray to God, I'll thank God. You know, I was a good person, I choose to be a human being. If you pass that, if you fail, then we will crush our own self. Hope that answers the question.